Buy a brick and lay the foundation for a school. That's a scheme being promoted in Iran to promote charity school building. It's a resolution significant enough for charities, donors, and officials to aim for New Year to complete projects. Projects consist of constructing, renovating, or refitting schools. Volunteer and charity work is a world popular, but imagine channeling any amount of resources towards school building. It's a big project doable with the accumulation of lots of small sums and efforts. In Iran, school building and donating to society is a tradition. Could do with a little backup from the law. For a word with all walks involved, stay with me, Leila Faramarzi, on Iran Today. The current Iranian calendar year, beginning March the 21st, saw a total budget of 48 trillion rials earmarked for school renovation nationwide. That's over $1 billion at the official exchange rate of 42,000 rials to the dollar, signifying a 65% increase year on year. The $1.1 billion budget is a difficult sum to muster up, but not much to spend with the rial devalued so badly. And so the Organization for Renovation, Development and Equipment of Schools of Iran cannot work alone. I got to talk to some private donors. Mr. Siavash doesn't even live in Iran and he's in the retail business, but still he cares to donate schools to Iran.
The fifth school I built myself has this problem. The roof of the school was collapsing, making it impossible for the students to study, so it was closed. I tried hard to find a volunteer, but no one cooperated. I don't want to break down the reason for it, but my hands are tied over such a matter. But I was determined to do that. I witnessed many things in the school because it was partly open and kids were coming in to study. The building was derelict and the roof was about to collapse any second. That was why I made the decision, and finally, the renovation organization cooperated with me, and thank God, we finished the school a few days ago.
An impressive donor I have to introduce to you is Mr. Baniadam. Let's hear him out.
Our educational spaces would be totally destroyed if it weren't for members of the charity. We would have had schools working in four shifts. Back at the beginning of the Islamic Revolution, there were schools that worked at three shifts. We had such schools in the southern parts of Tehran that changed shifts every other week. But thank to God, charity members came to our help and built 30% to 35% of the schools.
Iran has 450 school-building charities and 650,000 donors inside the country and 1,000 donors outside. It's benefactors that have constructed 30% of the country's schools. Mr. Ghorbani is the connecting thread between all my donors. Let's hear him.
We currently have about 30,000 charity school building members identified in the country. They are registered, about 20,000 of whom are male benefactors and 5,000 others female. There are also about 5,000 companies and legal entities that are active in the field of school construction. Up to 30% of our country's schools are built with the participation of donors. Very few countries in the world have this share of benefactors' participation in the construction and development of educational spaces.
President Hassan Rouhani himself officially inaugurated some 1,550 educational training and welfare projects across the country in November 2020 via video conferencing.
Basically, governments are tasked with policy making. Governments are concerned with where we should build schools and where the population needs schools. If you build schools somewhere that doesn't have enough students, it shows the policy has been wrong. The School Building Charity Association, as a grassroots organization, happens to play this very role. In other words, in addition to paying attention to the location of schools, we take into account how the schools are constructed, we make sure the intention of the benefactors is being observed, and we also ensure that the land use does not change afterwards. We're basically standing beside the benefactors and monitoring what the government does.
The projects included 1,422 educational places, with 8,051 classrooms, 124 training centres and 4 welfare centres, measuring a total of 1.1 million square metres. But why this urge to build schools when a strained economy makes more soup houses sound like the best idea of social service?
Unfortunately, the prisons are filled with people who lack education. By building one school, we can close down at least one prison. That's how I look at it. I may be wrong, but taking action, building schools is much better than doing nothing and putting the building off for months. We need to build it as long as we have the opportunity. Time flies, we can't sit idly for months. If we have reached a decision, we need to enact it. If we haven't decided what course of action to take, we need to make that decision fast.
The importance of schooling means zooming in on the remotest parts of a vast country of green plains, harsh mountains and dry deserts. There are over 1.5 million nomads in Iran today, divided by name but united by blood and nationality. Tribes such as the Bakhtiaris, Bactrians or Lors basically, and Kurds. There are currently 210,000 nomadic students studying in 14,000 classrooms across the country, and their numbers increased by 10% in a year beginning March 2019. Mr. Baniadam tells of his passion for school building and how he paired up with someone of his faith to act on his passion. Their latest project, he mentioned, was work on Tehran's District 22, which began 7-8 months ago. Land prices have gone through the roof, but it is the Ministry of Education that tends to provide the land for school building projects.
The first school I built was located somewhere called Alart, which was a village in the vicinity of Robat Karim. I was so happy with what I had done that I immediately started making the second, third, and fourth. I sold my lands and built schools. In about 20 years, the charity community built 30-35% of the schools in the entire country. Over the past 6-7 months, we have planned a biennial program. This planning has helped us maintain a very positive interaction with municipalities, city councils, the Minister of Education, and the renovation organization. Despite the coronavirus pandemic and oppressive sanctions, we have almost 55 schools that are about to open. During the next 7 months, the number is likely to rise to 100.
I was intent on finding out if school building we are talking of is actually a godly act. And donors said because of ownership disputes they've experienced in past, disputes that could endanger schools, they are now incredibly careful to build schools only on halal lands, lands that are legally and morally permissible.
The biggest problem we face in Tehran is the scarcity of land. If the lands are available, we can seek the help of the benefactors. We have great donors. We have benefactors like Mr. Ebrahimi, who has built 180 schools, Mr. Qalamchi with 170 schools, Mr. Davarpana with 300 schools, and so forth. These figures are on a national scale and not specifically in Tehran province. Dr. Khosro Shahi, may God rest his soul, built 428 schools. And we weren't even allowed to name him. He asked us to wait until after his death to mention his name.
Our MP of the day is a Ms. Qasemipur. She is MP for Kurdistan, Sanandaj.
Speaking of the scarcity of lands, I need to explain that the Ministry of Education has some lands. Either some honorable people dedicate their lands in our beloved country and give it to the ministry, or the municipalities set them off with the ministry. The lands are given to benefactors. Because the charity members have run into problems in the past, they insist that the lands must be in the name of the education ministry. Otherwise, they won't do any construction on the lands.
Education for all has also meant for the children of illegal immigrants, that is by the leader's decree of May 2015. Currently, some 110,000 illegal Afghan national students are studying in Iran. A total 88% of the refugees' children are studying in Iranian schools, and by next school year, beginning September the 23rd, that rate should increase to 90% in elementary schools. The Ministry of Education has allocated 10 trillion rials, nearly $240 million, for refugees' education. This is while international donations constitute only 2 to 2.5% of the amount. A gap this great has left the ministry facing major problems.
We have a good position in the field of construction. In 2017, our country won the Sasakawa International Award for the Safety of Educational Spaces. Sasakawa is an international award given to only two countries every year, and it was the first time that this award was given to the Iranian ambassador in Mexico. Iran won first place in strengthening educational spaces.
Each year, students in Iran start school on September the 23rd, after the three-month summer holiday. But with the coronavirus pandemic at large this year, all educational centers in the country have been closed since late February 2020. And education has been conducted in three forms: in-person, virtual, and television-based. Haven't heard anything on support for education or school building today, but it is naturally on the general agenda of Parliament, which is why we are here to hear it from an MP.
I have concentrated on this issue since I've been a member because I am an educator myself. I've had a meeting with the esteemed head of the renovation organization. He agreed to a special condition for me after I explained the situation in the region. The government usually engages with the benefactors in building schools and pays 50% of the costs. But the head of the renovation organization agreed to a 70-30 scenario, meaning the government would be responsible for 70% and the donors, 30%. That's because the students are in a very bad situation there. Based on per capita educational space and standards that exist in the country, I think there's half a meter of space for every student there.
Time for a short break. We'll be back in no time. The National Budget Bill for the next Iranian calendar year of March 2021 to 22 has foreseen a 21% rise for the renovation and retrofitting of schools. Over the past 4 years, the number of old classrooms in need of reconstruction and retrofitting has been reduced from 30% to 19.5%. Capital city Tehran has the highest number of old schools, but donors tend to donate in their own local hometowns or to deprived areas. There are some 107,000 schools nationwide with 530,000 classes, 160,000 of which are dilapidated and dangerous. That means 30% of the schools nationwide don't meet safety standards.
We give priority to esteemed benefactors who work hard to build schools in deprived regions. Because our main objective is educational equality and justice, students in deprived regions also have the right to use the same educational facilities and schools available elsewhere in our beloved Iran, so we need to start from there. The donors themselves want to spend their money somewhere that those who are really in need can benefit. Kurdistan province is one of those places, especially where my constituency is at. Because it's an immigrant-friendly city, there are 44,000 students there. The government doesn't have enough facilities to dedicate to the students, so we need to seek help from charity members.
If you examine the region itself, Tehran has more students compared to other cities. It's true that some rural areas lack schools altogether, but Tehran has a lower per capita space for every student. That's why Tehran needs much more schools than elsewhere.
Goes without say, with school building this high up on Iran's cultural agenda, in natural disaster, people waste no time in turning their eyes to the situation children find themselves in. And benefactors donated $48 million to rebuild flood-hit schools in 2018-19. The devastating floods hit 28 of Iran's 31 provinces, leaving some 1,500 schools damaged, 200 of which were razed to the ground. In the year from March 2018 to 2019, more than half of school classes were built by benefactors, and within a 10-year period, the number of dilapidated schools dropped from two-thirds to one-third.
One of the characteristics of the Iranian nation is our love for knowledge and culture. This isn't a simple claim. History has clearly shown that. For example, the development of educational spaces in our country dates back to at least 1,000 years ago. If we specifically consider schools and special spaces where education takes place, you can look at Rab Rashidi 800 years ago. Why is Rab Rashidi so famous? Rab Rashidi was a complex comprising four sections, and according to available data, it housed 5,000 students from around the world 800 years ago. Iranians have always been pioneers in the field of science and knowledge. Mirza Taghi Khan Amir Kabir built Darul Funun 160 years ago. That's another educational space built by a benevolent man.
More yet to come of our narration, but let's hear a word from others and taking a look at other media outlets in the meantime. And here's what other media outlets have to say. Irna quotes the leader. Education system should pursue formation of religious, just, ideal society, says Ayatollah Khamenei. The Islamic government was established on the basis of this goal, the formation of a religious, just, ideal society. Naturally, the education system of the country cannot pursue a goal in opposition to the overall goal pursued by the whole system. He said this on the occasion of National Teachers' Day. The leader outlined, children, the youth and young adults in our Islamic society learn that they should develop and utilize their talents and their potential capabilities on the path of achieving lofty national values, Islamic and revolutionary values. Islam invites us to acquire beneficial knowledge. On the one hand, beneficial knowledge equips young Iranians with the necessary tools for the progress and growth of their country and people. And on the other hand, it gives them identity and enriches them with dignity, psychological and spiritual esteem and self-confidence. We've a word from Tehran Times. If anything ever deserved high representation, school building ambassadors coming to aid education system. In line with the document of the fundamental transformation of education, people who have a popular reputation are being invited as ambassadors to attract public participation for school construction. The director of the Organization for Renovation, Development and Equipment of Schools said this. School building ambassadors have been selected in four provinces of the country so far, and we are going to have one school ambassador from each province, Irna quoted Mehrollah Rakhshani Mehra saying. It has always been thought that only a certain number of people can afford to build a school, but all people can participate even by buying a brick, he highlighted. He further explained that a system is set up in which under construction projects are introduced, and users can select each project and pay as much as they can to build the school. Not to forget the importance of UNICEF, the United Nations Children's Fund in Education, Tehran Times says, Education Ministry UNICEF Inc. MOU to enhance co-op. The Ministry of Education and United Nations Children's Fund have signed a Memorandum of Understanding to expand cooperation in 2021. Iran's Deputy Education Minister for International Affairs, Ghulam Reza Karimi, and UNICEF representative in Tehran, Mandeep O'Brien, discussed further cooperation in a meeting in Tehran. During the meeting, Karimi expressed readiness to cooperate with UNICEF to improve the quality of education in compliance with Iran's Islamic approaches. He discussed the activities of the Ministry of Education in combating the pandemic and school reopening and asked UNICEF to provide the ministry with the best global experiences in the field of education. The UNICEF representative praised Iran's efforts in education coverage, especially 99% student enrollment and the elimination of inequality in the education of girls and boys, and announced readiness to cooperate with Iran in intercultural education for refugees and to provide successful global experiences in education. That would be it for the news section. Some 2,500 public schools are operational in Tehran, and every year, 10 of them are added to a long list of dilapidated ones, while only 3 to 4 new schools are established annually. Since 2006, some 50% of the schools nationwide have been reconstructed, and the rest are waiting for budget allocation to be renovated. Tehran has been estimated to need roughly $250 million to rebuild ramshackle schools and another $110 million to make them earthquake resistant. Education means so much to Iranian society that even people with professions far from anything academic have involved themselves in school building. Mostly people with no other academic involvement, actually. Looking at the different uses some of their educational donations have been put into and what it has produced is touching. I was told by donors that the late Imam Khomeini himself gave 500 million riyals at time of war, which was divided between schools.
If you make an assessment, the culture of education and research has been growing since the Islamic Revolution. That is, for example, our students who win awards in the field of nanotechnology are mostly educated in less advantaged areas of the cities. We are now the world's sixth leading country in the field of nanotechnology. This shows that if the educational spaces are prepared for the use of our dear students, they enthusiastically use them to realize their great mission to achieve their higher cultural and educational goals.
But even with 110,000 schools and 550,000 classrooms in the country, roughly speaking, challenges remain. The country has 14 million school kids with 5 square meters of school space per kid. Classrooms of 32 students on average need to be reduced to 24 students. If you plan to become a donor, you should know donors can supervise school management.
If someone wants to join the school builder charity association, they can contact the association or the renovation organization by doing a simple internet search. They provide their primary information, including how much they're willing to spend and what they want to do. They can either come to Iran themselves or choose a relative, friend or an acquaintance to take care of their work as their representative. It's interesting to know that the latter method has become more frequently used recently. It wasn't as easy in the past. Now the benefactors know people who are well aware of the regulation and know what to do and how to build the schools.
The Charity Schools Association of Iran is the best place to raise this money. Most donors, for example, want to write a check in our name, but we do not accept it and tell them to deposit it in the account of the assembly. Even if the donors pay money to the renovation organization, the body transfers the sums to the association. The association has a lot of money and is decisive. The association sometimes completes semi-finished school projects because people have more trust in it than the other organizations.
Going by 2018 information, while in the 1970s the enrollment rate of the boys and girls in primary education was 70%, this currently exceeds 98%. There are elementary schools in almost all areas across the country, and in some regions there are elementary schools with just one student.
We have three historical periods in school construction in Iran. One was Darul Funun, another period goes back to the time of Rushdie and Bakhchaban, who found the schools for deaf students. The third one is the modern era. We are now looking to construct schools that would meet all educational needs of students while being a safe and comfortable environment that can fully withstand natural disasters.
Well, Iran has long had a strong educational base to build on, and it has done so. Talking of children in schools, it's not to say there are no out-of-school children, but numbers of out-of-school kids in primary school age have dwindled. It is noteworthy enrollment of boys and girls in primary education is almost equal in Iran.
Our noble benefactors work really hard and make sacrifices. This is because they realize that a transcendent society needs an educational environment that promotes culture. We are thankful to God that now Iran is rich in culture. Members from UNESCO visited Iran at the invitation of the renovation organization. We took them for a tour of the schools built by donors. It was totally unbelievable for them. They said, how is it possible for a person to donate such astronomical amounts to build a school? When we told them that someone holds a record of building 428 schools, they couldn't believe it. Most of the members told us, you should win the Nobel Peace Prize.
That's it for today. Thanks for watching from the whole team. Do return to the box at the same times next week and each week after, as you never know what's on. And remember to leave your comments and topic requests. Wishing you all the best for the new year, I bid you farewell.